Listen, we've got to quit right here and now. Right here in the middle of round two. Will you come back next time?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Look forward to seeing both Susan and Tom next time. Now, let's see. Did we have any unfinished business here? Now, listen, tell me more about this movie. Are you shooting it now?
Yes, it's a movie Joan Rivers wrote. It's called Rabbit Test. And it's about a boy that gets pregnant.
Jimmy Coco's in it? No, wait a minute. Who's in this?
Oh, everybody.
Everybody's in it. Yeah. Now, this is done in that remarkable new process in which they shoot on videotape, edit on videotape, and then they have some miraculous way of transferring it to 35-millimeter film.
Yeah, I don't know how they do it.
It's a real new technological innovation.
Can I ask you a question?
Yes.
How come you never stop and ask me what I'm doing?
What are you doing, Scully?
No, how do you know I'm not doing anything? That's what I really want to know.
Well, we got you here, didn't we? Yeah.
At the last minute.
Yeah, that's right. Join us next time for Match Game 77. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 77, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattle Tales next over most of these CBS stations.
From Hollywood, it's the Newlywed Game. And here are today's newlyweds. This couple exchanged their vows 15 months ago, Lydia and Blake Shellhammer. Our next couple tied the knot 22 months ago, Carrie and Michael Bauman. This couple walked down the aisle 24 months ago, Terry Joe and Jeff Slater. And our final couple traded rings 15 months ago, Dia and John Langston. And now, here's the star of the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubanks.
Welcome to the Newlywed Game. And a special hello to our four couples. You ready to play the game?
Yeah!
Then I'll tell you what let's do. Let's ask the ladies to go off to our soundproof room. I'll ask the husbands some questions, okay?
All right.
There you go. And gentlemen, in round one, we'll be asking you some five-point questions. You'll be answering these questions, I hope, as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. If her answer matches your prediction, you then get 5 points. And guess what? It's the one couple with the most points at the end of the show that wins that fabulous second honeymoon. So, gentlemen, if you are ready, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Well, I hope you're ready, because I want you to meet a friend of mine. Victoria, would you come out here, please? Victoria. Oh, guys. Yes. Hi, Victoria. Now, yeah. Oh, Blake over there went, Gentlemen, if you woke up in the middle of the night and you found Victoria in bed next to you where your wife should be, exactly how long will your wife say it would take you to file a missing persons report? So you're going to wake up now, John.
Well, my wife is pregnant. If that lady woke up in bed with me, I'd know something was strange by feeling that missing part of my wife's body. So
just answer the question,
call
John.
A second.
How long?
Say a minute.
A minute. So you'd call right away then?
Immediately.
No kidding. Okay. Michael, how long would it take you to file a missing persons report? Michael, look at her face, please.
I'd say maybe a week.
A week? All right.
Might take me a week.
There's an honest man. I like that. Blake, what do you think about this?
I don't know. I'd say maybe a year.
A year? Okay. And Jeff.
It'd definitely be a day.
One day.
A long day.
Oh, a long day. All right. Thank you very much, Victoria. All right. Next question, gentlemen. Gentlemen, scientifically speaking, what will your wife say you think is wrong with all women? Scientifically speaking, Michael, what do you think is wrong with all women?
What I think is wrong with all women?
Same question I asked you, Michael. It's amazing how we do that.
I think they nag too much, scientifically.
Scientifically, they nag too much.
Nag too much, scientifically.
I'm glad you're being very scientific about this. Blake?
Well, scientifically, men are more right-brained and women are more left-brained.
So scientifically speaking?
So scientifically speaking, I don't have a clue, really.
Well, give me an answer.
That's all, man. You know, we just don't have a clue.
Scientifically speaking, what do you think is wrong with all women?
I think they're too uptight.
They're too uptight?
Too uptight.
Okay. Jeff?
They think too much.
They think too much.
Just need to go with it.
Go with the flow. John?
Too bossy, man.
They're too bossy.
Yeah, like too bossy.
Yeah. Hey. This is the guy that's going to file a report 1 minute later. He's a very smart man. The last of our five-point questions. Gentlemen, the next time that you're serving up an evening of passion, will your wife say she wishes you would add more spice, more appetizers, or more specials? What do you think, Blake?
More specials.
Specials. Jeff?
More specials.
Specials. John?
Spice.
Spice. And Michael?
Definitely more specials.
All right. Thank you, gentlemen. We'll be right back to reunite these newlyweds. We'll see how well our husbands have predicted what their wives will say right after these messages.
Playtime.
I'm gonna say the beach.
You're gonna say the beach also? He said at the beach.
Tomorrow, starting at noon.
Come on over.
Buzzer is the place to play.
Let's do it.
With our most popular shows. Ludden.
Ellen.
Because play makes your day.
We have a little mild hysteria out here, fellas.
That's why daytime is playtime.
Every day you must watch.
Tomorrow, starting at noon Eastern. Only on Buzzer. Let's play.
Back to the newlywed game. The ladies are back. And gentlemen, we've recorded your predictions on cards. You now have them in front of you. Each time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you get 5 points. One couple at the end of the show that has the most points wins a great second honeymoon. And ladies, we had such a good time while you were gone. Let me show you why we had such a good time. Victoria, would you join me, please? I want you ladies to meet Victoria. Now, ladies, think about this one, ladies. That's why it took so long for round one.
Hey.
If your husband woke up in the middle of the night and found Victoria in bed next to him, where you should be, exactly how long would it take him to file a missing persons report? Terry Joe, what do you think? How long would it take him to file a missing persons report? He wakes up and she is next to him, and how long is it going to be before he tries to find you?
5 minutes.
5 minutes. All
yes.
Right. Oh,
I
close.
5 minutes.
Yeah, he said for sure it would take one long day.
Oh,
we were so embarrassed.
Why? You,
when he said, I was so embarrassed when he said that.
No.
Oh, yeah.
That'd take you for all life.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. Pretty much.
Lydia, he wakes up now, and there Victoria is, and you're not there. How long is it going to take him to file a missing persons report?
10 seconds.
10 seconds. Good. You know what your husband said?
He better
say. He said
that.
It would take him about 1 year.
Oh my God!
Yeah, it goes by quick. Yeah.
Oh, I told you.
You mean it go by quick with her?
No,
is what
I
you're
know.
Saying?
You
get gray hair then.
Uh-huh.
Carrie, how long do you think he said?
1 second for sure.
1 second for sure. He said it would take him for sure. All right, 1 week.
Oh my God!
You're out. Somebody call a cab, please, for Michael. Dia, what do you think he said?
Let's see, it takes a half a second to look at her and a half a second to pick up the phone. He better have said 1 second.
All right. He said it would take him, 1 minute. No. But that's
okay.
Pretty good.
Oh. Okay.
Thank you, Victoria.
Thank you.
You missed it. Husband number three just kissed his wife on the arm and she slapped the heck out of him. Next question, ladies. Scientifically speaking, what does your husband think is wrong with all women? Scientifically speaking, Lydia, what does he think is wrong with all women?
They're all more like all surgical boobs.
I'll beg your pardon, ma'am? They have surgical what?
Yeah, because he says they float on the swimming pool if they go swimming.
Can I ask you a question, Lydia?
Yes.
Do you float in the swimming pool?
Well, no.
No?
Because I'm flat.
Oh, you're flat. Blake said scientifically he thinks what's wrong with women, they're too uptight. I don't think he meant uptight that way. This will. That's all. What do you think, Carrie? What do you think he said?
I think he would say women nag too much.
They nag too much. He said scientifically women nag too much. Yeah. Dia.
But this is easy because he always tells me that I get it from all my female
what is it?
Friends. Bossy.
Bossy. He said women are too bossy. Yeah. Terry Joe, scientifically speaking.
I would say that we don't have our priorities straight.
Don't have your okay. Jeff says scientifically speaking, what's wrong with women? Top card for me, please. Is you think too much.
Where's that cab?
Oh,
this one
the cab. Michael's got the cab.
Oh, Michael. Yeah.
We're sharing, Michael.
Yeah. No, Michael's already sharing with Victoria. Yeah.
Yeah. This is true.
Next question, ladies. Next time that your husband is serving up an evening of passion, do you wish that he would add more specials, more spice, or more appetizers? The next time, Carrie, I mean, he does serve up an evening of passion, doesn't he?
Every now and then. Every now and
I
then.
See. Do you all wish right. he would serve up more specials, more spice, or more appetizers?
More appetizers.
More appetizers. Oh, he said more specials.
More specials.
Dia, do you want him to serve up more specials, spice, or appetizers?
Definitely more appetizers.
More appetizers. He said definitely more spice. More spice.
Spice. We got enough spice. We got plenty of spice.
Terry Joe.
Yes.
More special spice or appetizers?
It better be appetizers.
Appetizers.
Jeez.
See, you guys
don't.
Now, specials!
Do I know you?
You guys
honey,
have no points at all.
It's always the same way, every time.
Really?
So why
don't you want more
not?
Specials?
No, I want
it's always
little,
the same way.
I always.
Really?
Same.
Boring.
Boring.
He's not
Sports
very romantic,
center.
Is he?
Why is he not?
No. I mean, this is the guy that wants to hang on to Victoria for a whole day.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, I know. Yeah. 24 hours.
Well, yeah. Conflicting schedules. You work nights.
Okay.
Well, whose fault is it that it's always the same way?
His.
Why?
Because. He watches too much football.
Oh, so.
There's a good reason. Do you get a two-minute warning in halftime?
Yeah.
Lydia.
Yes?
More specials, more spice, or more appetizers?
My God, that's a big dilemma.
I know it is. It really is.
It's just, I will have to go to appetizers.
Appetizers. Okay. Is there a little problem with our love life, is there?
I think so.
Yeah. What do you think the problem is?
I think with me.
What's wrong with you?
Because, you know, sometimes I come home, I'm stressed out from my work.
Yeah.
And I go to school, I'm stressed out too.
Yeah.
So it takes a little while for me to really wind up. And I sometimes don't. I don't even sometimes.
So
I need to have a wine.
He needs to wind you up a little bit.
Right, wind it up a little bit.
So appetizers. He said next time he's going to give you more specials.
Specials.
Oh, my God.
We'll be back with the wives to see how well they can predict what their husbands will say right after these messages. Back to the Newlywed Game. Ladies, your husbands are now secluded off stage. It's your turn to predict what they're going to say. Remember, each of these questions will now be worth 10 points. So here we go. Ladies, when it comes to romance, will your husband say he is mostly right-handed, left-handed, or ambidextrous? What is he, Carrie?
Ambidextrous.
He's ambidextrous, okay.
Yeah, he can get busy with both.
He can get busy with both. That's what Vicky said when she was out here. Yeah. Lydia.
Ambidextrous.
He is. What does ambidextrous mean?
Oh, he can use everything he wants.
Oh, wow. Okay. Terry Joe.
Yeah. I would say left-handed.
He's left-handed. And Dia?
definitely right-handed.
He's right-handed.
He has all the right moves.
All the right moves. Next question. Ladies, before or since getting married, doesn't matter to me, what will your husband say was the last name you uttered in bed other than his? Lydia, this is before or since getting married. The last name that you uttered in bed other than his.
I never said anything.
Oh, you got to have an answer.
Oh, okay. All right. Chambers.
Chambers?
Yes.
Who's Chambers?
He's dead now.
Oh, sorry.
But he was the best.
You killed him, huh?
You know that.
Well,
you
that sucker that. Was ambidextrous, wasn't he? Yeah. Terry Joe.
Joey.
Ooh, look at her smile.
It's Joey.
All right. Take you a long time to file a missing report and be next to Joey, wouldn't it?
Yeah, that's right.
Dia.
Jonathan.
Carrie.
Tony.
Pardon me?
Boney.
Oh, I don't know about that. Here's our 25-point bonus question, ladies. What will your husband say is his favorite airline? Dia?
TWA.
Carrie?
Southwest.
Lydia?
United Airlines.
United. Terry Joe.
Southwest.
Thank you, ladies. It's been fun. We'll be back with the husbands to compare answers on the Newlywed Game right after these messages. Newlywed Game. Two of our couples have 5 points. Couple number one and two are just having a good time as we play this game. We'll see if you can't get some points now because these are the 10-point questions as we see how well the wives have predicted what the husbands will say. Gentlemen, here's your first one. When it comes to romance, would you say that you're mostly ambidextrous, right-handed, or left-handed? Blake, are you mostly ambidextrous, right-handed, or left-handed when it comes to romance?
Ambidextrous.
Really?
Yeah.
No kidding. How long you been that way?
all my life.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, as far as lovemaking is concerned, but writing and stuff.
You've been making love all your life?
Well, you know, I mean, as long as I've been able to. Like.
Oh, I see. Lydia predicted that you definitely are, card please, ambidextrous.
Yeah.
Boy, that was a romantic kiss. Smack.
No tongue, though.
Yeah. Hey. About you, Michael?
I'll say right-handed.
You're right-handed. She said when it comes to romance, you are ambidextrous.
Oh, come on, man.
I said you were good with both your hands. I guess I was wrong.
How come you called her ma'am?
Ma'am.
Oh, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Oh. John.
I think I'm, somewhat skewed. I say ambidextrous, Bob.
You what, sir?
Ambidextrous, whatever the word was.
Oh. How you spell that?
You know how to spell it.
Oh, okay. Dia says you are definitely right-handed.
Right, right. You do all the right moves. You ain't that skilled that you can use. Oh.
Jeff.
Ambidextrous.
You're ambidextrous. No, you're left-handed, pal.
Left-handed?
I'm always on the right side of you. What hand do you use? Jeez. Sorry. Sorry.
What about when you're in the middle?
Why are you sorry?
He's got a lot of explaining to do when we get home.
I think we need to communicate more.
Next question. Gentlemen, before or since you were married, what was the last name your wife uttered in bed other than yours? Michael?
She's never uttered it.
Oh, yes, she has, pal. She gave me... Hey, Michael,
never
let me say this.
No other
Michael,
name.
She gave me an answer just like that.
Oh, yeah. Would have been honey or baby. It wasn't
What's the last
else.
Name, Michael? She gave me an answer.
What was the last name?
Yeah.
Mike.
Mike. All right. She Mike. Said that she uttered Tony.
What's she tripping on, Tony? What?
Ah, Tony. Who's
I
Tony?
I didn't, but...
Who's Tony?
She's lying.
I had to say something.
Oh.
You should have said my name, Mike.
I didn't
think of that.
That's
the last word you uttered.
Hmm. I said other
than
yours.
What was her name again, Victoria?
Yeah, her name is Vicky. Victoria, yeah.
Tony.
Yeah. John. Hurry, please.
That's a hard one, Bob.
She didn't have any trouble with it.
Don't say that about my wife, man. Kenneth?
Kenneth, all right. No, see, you know who she said? She uttered Jonathan.
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 Oh, Jonathan, baby.
Oh. No. Oh. That's okay. That's all right.
I don't want to know.
Get a kiss for that. Get over that.
Jeff.
It would be Bob.
Oh, thank you very much. How about Joey?
Joey. Jesus. Joey.
Who is Joey?
Can we say that here?
No, no, no. Blake.
I have to say the judge.
Who?
The judge.
The judge?
The judge.
All right. She said that she uttered, card for me, please. No, Chambers.
Chambers.
You know Chambers? He's dead.
That's Chambers. The one that's the judge's last name is Chambers.
How did I know that?
Why did you not remember all the time? You always
sure,
don't remember anyway.
I can't remember the last name of somebody. I can barely remember the first name.
You're right.
Yeah, the judge's Chambers. Last name, Chambers. Before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our winning couple will be going on their second honeymoon. Take a look. Kramer?
You're going to the Caribbean. Spice Island Beach Resort, located on magnificent Grand Anse Beach in Grenada. Features luxurious accommodations, water sports, and fantastic dining. Picturesque surroundings and an intimate setting make Spice Island Beach Resort in Grenada the preferred Caribbean getaway. Back to you, Bob.
All right, John, thank you very much. Gentlemen, here it is, your 25-point bonus question. As we find out who's going to the Caribbean. Gentlemen, what is your favorite airline? Let's go to couple number one. Jeff and Terry Joe, you have zero. 25 will zoom you into first place. If you miss this one, you go home dead last with no points. What's your answer?
Favorite airline? Southwest.
Southwest. That's what she said, Southwest. All right. Couple number three, Michael and Kerry with 525 to give you 30. Michael, take over the lead with the correct answer.
Southwest.
Southwest, he said Southwest. Couple number four, John and Dia with 525 gives you 30. Get it right and you're tied for the lead.
Delta.
Delta, she said. TWA.
Tell them that we fly out of 10.
All right, couple number two. Blake and Lydia with 10, 25, and give you 35. Blake, if you get it right, you and your wife are going to the Caribbean. What is your answer, please?
I would say Delta.
Delta. Your wife said it would be United. That means a couple number three. Michael and Kelly. Your Newlywed Game grand prize winner. Congratulations to Michael and Carrie. Thanks to all of our couples, and thanks to you. I'm Bob Eubanks. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
It's the Newlywed Game! And here are today's newlyweds. This couple exchanged rings 2 months ago, Andrea and Jason Wakefield. Our next couple recited their vows 7 months ago, Faith and Eddie Heck. This couple joined together 7 months ago, Hope and Todd Evans. And our final couple made it official 13 months ago, Corinne and William Pulliam. And now, here's the star of the Newlywed Game, Bob Eubanks!
Hey! Thank you! Hello, everybody! Welcome to the Newlywed Game. And a special hello to our four couples. Are you ready to play?
Yeah!
Then, ladies, off you go to our soundproof room. I'll ask the husband some questions. Now, gentlemen, around one, we'll be asking you some five-point questions. You'll be answering these questions as you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. Now, remember, if her answer matches your prediction, you then get 5 points. And also remember, each correct prediction brings you that much closer to that fabulous second honeymoon. So the ladies are gone, and here's your first question. Gentlemen, I want you to do me a big favor, if you would, please. Take a look at the monitor right over there. Can you take a look at that monitor? All right. Now, you're going to see pictures of today's wives, including your wife. My question to you is, which one will she say you think would be the toughest wife? Now, first of all, let's take a look at wife number one. Here's wife number one. All right, now here's wife number two. There she is. And now, here's wife number three. There's wife number three. And now, here's wife number four. All right, now, once again the question, which one will she say you think would be the toughest wife? William?
Well, Bob, I have to say wife number three.
Wife number three, you think is tough?
She looks pretty mean.
Scared the heck out of me. Yeah. You're right.
Oh, my goodness.
Eddie, what do you think?
I would say my wife, number three.
Number three.
Yeah, I know her.
So William was right.
Yes, she is mean.
She is mean, yeah.
She is mean.
Jason?
I would have to say couple number four.
No, not couple. There's just one of them.
I'm sorry.
Your wife
four.
Number four?
Wife number four, you think? Yeah.
She's the mean.
I saw her set William straight back in the green
room.
Oh,
you did? Okay. What do you think, Todd? Would it be your wife or two, three, or four?
I think I'd have to go with Jason. I think wife number four.
Wife number four.
I saw her take care of William.
The toughest wife. All right. Next question, gentlemen. At which one of the four specific parts of her legs will your wife say the perfect 10 theory begins to fall apart? Jace, what do you think? You got that question?
Yeah, I'm going to have to go with her quad. She's always saying
her what?
Her quads, the top of her legs.
Oh, the quads. I knew that. Yeah. What do you think, Todd?
I would have to say her feet. She's a beautiful gal, but her
ugly feet.
Just not a 10.
Not a 10 on the old foot.
No, the rest is a 10.
Right. Yeah, bailout sucker. William.
I have to say her thighs.
Her thighs?
Yes.
No kidding.
Yeah, her thighs. You know, the bottom part is nice, but the thighs, when it starts to get to the thighs, is, well, you know, Bob.
No, I... How in the heck would I know about your wife's legs? First of all, she's the meanest woman I've ever met.
Oh, you too, huh?
Yeah, Eddie.
I'd have to see her feet.
Her feet?
Yeah, her feet are bigger than mine.
No.
Yeah.
What size foot does she have?
11.
11? Holy cow. She's taller when she lays down than she is when she stands up.
That's true. Yeah.
Well, thank you, gentlemen. We'll be right back to reunite these newlyweds. We'll see how well our husbands can predict what their wives will say. That's these messages.
Darkness falls upon your streets to possess your eyes with tricks and treats. No one can resist the wills to watch these Halloween chills and thrills. Starts October 29th only on Boozer.
Okay, gentlemen, we've recorded your predictions on cards. You have them in front of you. Each time that your prediction matches your wife's answer, you get 5 points. And guess what? So one couple at the end of the show has the most points. Great second honeymoon. Not only that, I'm going to give you a chance to win a color television, ladies, right now. Because, let me tell you why. While you were gone, we asked your husbands to pick the toughest wife. Okay? But before we see their answers, we're going to determine who that is with a little arm wrestling contest. So what I want to do now is wife number one and wife number four, would you come over here? Yeah. All right. Now, gentlemen, don't hold up any cards until I ask for them. All right, so let's get down like this, girls. And wait till I say go now. On your mark, get set, and go! Stay right over here. Now, number two, number three, would you come over here, please? You stay right here because you won, Steve, so far. Who knows, you might win a color television. Yeah. That's okay. Okay, now this is wife number two and wife number three. All right. Man, this is exciting for me. Okay. Let's get it out here. Okay. No swearing. And your mark, you said, go! Yeah! All right. Come on over here. Now, let me remind you. The winner wins a color television. Okay.
Come on, baby.
Right down here.
Come on.
Right down here. No cheating. Let's get them together. Everybody comfortable? Everybody ready? Oh no, you're not. I don't like it. There we are. Right there. Go.
Go, honey. Go.
Yeah! All right. Whoa.
Yes.
Wow. So wife number three turned out to be the toughest wife in the show. We're going to see how well, though, the husbands have predicted what the wives will say. Hope, who do you think your husband predicted would be the toughest wife on the show? One, two, three, or four?
I would say number three. She looks like she can take anyone down.
Yeah.
No problem.
And did, by the way.
Yes,
all right.
Did.
Todd said he thinks the toughest wife in the show would be wife number four. Ooh. Wife number four. All right. Okay. Andrea, would it be one, two, three, or four?
I would have to say three also.
Number three, your husband thought that wife number four would be the toughest wife. Okay. Faith, did your husband say one, two, three, or four?
Three.
He said, I know my wife. You got it. Yeah. All right, Corinne, what do you think he said? One, two, three, or four?
Four.
He said four. Your husband said wife number three. But ladies, thank you very much. That was a lot of fun. And
like
Faith
that?
And Eddie, you have a color television set. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Next question now. Ladies, tell me, at which of the four specific parts of your legs would you say the perfect 10 theory begins to fall apart? Faith?
I'd say my thighs.
Your thighs. He predicted you would say it would be, card please, your feet.
Well, they are pretty big.
What? That's not part of my legs, though, is it?
Yes,
he said
it
your
is.
Feet are bigger than his.
That's true. I'm a big girl, Bob. I need big feet.
It's okay. Corinne?
I would say my thighs.
Your thighs. Your husband predicted you would say it would be your thighs.
Yeah.
What do you think, Hope?
Definitely go with the thighs, Bob.
Thighs, Bob.
Yes.
He said that, he said you're a very pretty lady, he says, except for the card. He says, you got feet. Feet,
you always kiss my toes.
What? He does what?
He kisses my toes.
No.
Yes.
That's true love.
But, you said she had ugly feet.
Let's find out what number two said.
Oh, okay. I'll move on, huh? Yeah. Andrea, what do you say?
Definitely my thighs.
Your thighs. He predicted to be the old quads. I assume that's the same thing, right? Okay, we'll be back with the wives. You see how they predict what their husbands will say right after these messages.
Thank you.
welcome back, everybody. Ladies, your husbands are now secluded off stage. It's your turn to predict what they will say. And remember, these are the big ones. These are the 10-point questions. Hey, tell me, ladies, which of the following will your husband admit is the least sexy thing about him? Is it his voice, his chest, his butt, or his hair? Least sexy, Faith, about him. Which one's the least
I'll
sexy?
I'll say his butt.
His butt's not very
only
sexy.
Only I like everything, but just because I have to choose, I'll say his butt.
Okay, fine. Andrea? Least sexy.
He would say his chest. He's yeah, he would definitely say his
chest. Why would
chest.
That?
I like his chest.
But what does he say wrong with it?
Probably not as tough as it used to be.
Not as tough as it used to be.
Yeah.
Hope.
I would definitely go with chest also.
His chest. Okay, Corinne?
I would say his chest, because his chest is sunken in and his stomach comes out. So if they were to reverse, then he'd be perfect.
Ladies, during which sports season will your husband say he becomes the most sexually aroused? During which sports season would that be, Andrea?
Baseball. He is a baseball freak. He's always played it. He's won championships. Baseball.
Baseball. Turns him on.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The stick is like that for a reason, you know, Bob. Oh. The baseball bat and that.
Sounds to me like he's hit more than 62 himself.
Football. Definitely tackling.
Oh, like that tackling stuff.
Likes the tackling. Yeah.
I see. Corinne?
Basketball. I could stand in the nude in front of the TV. You wouldn't even know I was there.
Well, make sure. So he becomes the most sexually aroused during basketball?
Right. With himself.
Oh. Okay. Sounds good. Faith?
I'll have to say baseball. It's his favorite sport, and he likes all of them, but baseball. He gets pretty excited
about. All right, fine. Here's the last of our 10-point questions. Ladies, if you were a man, this is a great question. Listen to this one. If you were a man for one full day, what will your husband say is the first thing that you would go out and do? The one thing you'd go out and do if you were a man for a full day. Hope, what would you do?
Probably go watch a football game with the guys.
Go watch a football game with the guys.
Sure.
Okay. Corinne, what would you do? You're a man for a full day.
I'd go out and paint the town and party all day.
So you go
night.
Party all day.
Yeah, I would. That's what I would do.
Okay. Faith, what would you do?
I would drive a big semi-truck.
You'd just drive a big old truck?
Yeah.
Andrea, what
only
would you do?
Because I can't think of anything else.
Go into the men's restroom with no waiting.
Way to go, yeah. 25-point bonus question. Ladies, in one word, and only one word, how will your husband say he likes his pork? One word, Corinne.
Barbecued.
Is that one word? Barbecued? It is. Okay. If you say it fast, it's one. Barbecued. Okay.
Barbecued.
Faith?
I'll say well.
Well?
I don't know how he likes his pork. I don't think we've even had pork, but oh. Well.
Andrea?
He would like it on ribs. But I don't eat meat. So
ribs.
I think pork
Hope?
Ribs.
Mexican.
Mm-hmm. Carne.
Sounds good to me.
Carnitas.
Yeah. Ladies, thank you. We'll be back with the husbands to compare answers on the Newlywed Game right after these messages. Hey, welcome back, everybody. Okay, we're having a good time today. Three of our couples have 5 points. Couple number one doesn't have any points yet. However, you still have lots of time to catch up. We're going to see how well the wives have predicted what their husbands will say. And remember, these are the 10-point questions. So here's our first one. Gentlemen, which of the following would you admit is the least sexy thing about you? Is it your chest, your voice, your hair, or your butt? Jason, what is the least sexiest about you? Chest, voice, hair, or butt?
My hair, Bob.
Your hair?
Yeah.
Your hair, Bob, okay. Yeah. Andrea said the least sexy thing about you is your chest.
My chest.
I love your hair.
She just doesn't like your chest.
No, that's not it either.
Oh, that's not it? Eddie, what is the least sexy thing about you? You have to admit, is it your chest, your voice, your hair, or your butt?
I would have to say my butt.
How come?
It's big.
Oh.
It's just big. It's there.
It's there, huh?
Yep.
All right. She said the least sexy thing about you is your butt. That's right. William.
I have to say my chest.
How
She's
come?
She's always kidding me about my hairy chest. And I don't even have any hair on my chest.
Not one?
Not one strand.
Let me see.
See, I mean, it's nothing.
Huh?
Nothing there.
Nothing.
Nothing at all.
She says the least sexy thing about you, card for me, please. For a different reason, she said, your chest. That's right. Okay. Top.
Bob, I'd have to say my butt.
Your butt, Bob. Okay. Hope said it would be your chest, Bob. Your chest is the least sexy thing about you, Todd.
You have a cute butt, honey.
But I have a cute chest, too.
I know. He does. It's
you're wearing that manly shirt, and you're telling me you got a cute chest? Next question, gentlemen. Think about this one. This is an important question. During which sports season would you say you become the most sexually aroused? Eddie, which sports season do you become the most sexually aroused?
Baseball.
Baseball. She thought you would say it would be baseball. Yes. Yeah. William.
Basketball. That's my favorite sport.
Really? Basketball.
I love basketball.
All right. She says, card for me, please. It is your chest.
My chest?
Yeah, your chest.
What's that got to do with it?
Yeah. That's my favorite sport, too.
Basketball! Todd?
I would have to say baseball.
Baseball. Your wife said it would definitely be football. You become.
Honey, football, the Chargers.
We met at a Padres game. I mean, we had to go with baseball.
He's so romantic.
Yeah. Jason?
Well, considering that I am a baseball player, I would have to say baseball.
Baseball. She said, considering it'd be baseball. Okay. All right, next question, gentlemen. Think about this one now. If your wife were a man for one full day, she's a man for one full day, what's the first thing she would go out and do? William.
Smoke a cigarette.
Smoke a cigarette.
I have no idea, Bob.
Well, now she said she was a man for her first day, she would just go party all day.
Oh, come on.
Well, I would.
It's what guys do, isn't it?
I go bar hopping and everything.
That's not what every guy does.
I mean, you know. Scratch and all that stuff. Todd?
I would have to say, man or woman, she'd go shopping.
Shopping? No, she said she would watch a football game with the guys.
We still got zero.
Yeah, you did. Jason, man for a full day, what would she go out and do?
For a whole day.
Yeah. First thing she'd do. Hurry, please.
Maybe sit around the house and watch a game like I do usually
okay
on the weekends.
Andrea said the first, what she would do, it was she'd go into the men's restroom where there's no waiting.
I hate waiting, you know that.
That's true,
and
that's
there's
true
never a line with the guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's terrible.
What do you think, Eddie?
That's a tough question. I'd probably have to say go to a baseball game.
No, you know what she said if she had a man for a full day? She'd go out and drive a big old semi-truck. Before we get to our 25-point bonus question, let's see where our winning couple will be going on their second honeymoon. Kramer!
You're going to Mexico! You'll stay at the Hotel Cabo San Lucas, a complete beach resort where you can do everything under the sun or nothing at all. White sand beaches, elegant dining, and deluxe accommodations, all with private terraces. The perfect second honeymoon. Back to you, Bob.
All right, John, thank you very much. Gentlemen, here is your 25-point bonus question for 25 points. Gentlemen, in one word, and only one word, how do you like your pork? That's the funniest question I've heard. Couple number one, Todd and Hope with zero. Get it right, and you're tied for first place. Miss it, and you go home. One word, how do you like your pork?
Cooked.
Cooked, she said. One word, you like it. Card, please.
Oh, my God.
Mexican. Couple number two, Jason and Andrea with 15, 25, and give you 40. Get it right, you're in first place. And one word, Jason, how do you like your pork?
Barbecue.
Barbecued. She said, you like it. Ribs. Ribs.
Ribs.
Couple number three, Eddie and Faith with 25, 25, and give you 50. Get it right, and you will be in first place. Eddie.
Ribs.
Ribs. She said, well.
I just thought, well done. I didn't know what they were asking.
Couple number four, William and Corinne with 25, 25, and give you 50. William, if you get it right, you and your wife are going on a fabulous, fabulous second honeymoon. How do you like your pork?
Cooked.
Cooked, she said.
Barbecue.
Barbecue.
We always love barbecue.
Okay, that means we've got a tie. Now, before the show, each couple predicted what their final score would be. Hang with me on this one, folks. This is really a toughie. The couple that comes closest to their final score will win. If both predictions are equally distant from the actual score, then the one that did not go over the final score wins. If you can figure that crap out, you're better than I am. Let's see. Couple number three. You have 25 points. Your prediction's right alongside of you. You predict 37. You went over, and you went over by 12 points, okay? Couple number four. You have 25 points, William. You predicted 42. That means a couple number three, Eddie and Faith. Yeah! Winners! Well, congratulations to Eddie and Faith. Thanks to all of our couples. Most of all, thanks to you. I'm Bob Eubanks. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.